Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. I'm going to go through today how we can combine audiences in Mailchimp where we want the groups and the tags to be the same. I'll take you across to Mailchimp. You'll see I'm in Mailchimp at the moment and here I have four audiences. But for example, say I want to combine the old audience into the master. And you, of course, might have multiple audiences that you want to do this with. And this is very common. Now, I have a very popular video on YouTube that shows the Mailchimp Combine, which when we click the down arrow, we could go combine. Oops, I'm in the way there. Let me just move myself out the way just very briefly. And you'll be able to see that we can click the down arrow and combine audiences. The advantage with that is it's very quick and simple using the combine audiences in Mailchimp. You can do, the disadvantage is you can only do one audience at a time. But the biggest disadvantage with that is tags and groups don't come across. And particularly if you have large audiences, several hundred thousand or tens of thousands or millions of contacts, you might want to condense your audiences, but you don't want to lose those groups and so on. Please be aware that the method I'm showing you today needs to be done in a specific order, which I will illustrate, but also your reporting will not come across. So you will lose the reporting from your old, or the old audience, let's call it, won't come across. So I'm going to show how we, again, just to be clear, how we can combine the old audience with the master audience. What I'm going to do, and I'm sorry, this is a bit of backwards and forwards in my screen. I'm going to go through various steps, nine different steps. Now, just before we get going, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It would really help. Please also like this video, leave a comment. I'd very much appreciate it. So we're going to go through these nine steps. I won't go through them right now. The first one, though, is backup an existing audience. So let's go back to Mailchimp, and you'll notice that this is the old one. So let's just go into this audience very quickly. And to backup, what I mean by that is just export your audience, just so you have a copy. We will work with it, but also just so you have a reference point. So click export audience and download it to your computer and store it safely. Let's go across again and see what the next step is. Select or create the master audience. Just going back, and I'm going to view all our audiences. So what I'm going to be doing is merging the old and any other ones I wanted to, but only the old in this case, with the master audience. If you don't have a master audience, so I could be combining it into organicweb.com.au or any other audience, but I happen to have created a new master audience that I will combine my audience into. Going back, create groups. This is a critical step, so please do this at this stage. If I go back to my old audience, I'm going to go into my old audience, and if you use groups, what we will see is under manage contacts and groups, I've got a group called interests, and if I view my groups, I've got Australia and USA underneath. I need to create these groups exactly as they are in the new, in the master audience. So let's go to the master audience. We're going to create the group called interests with Australia and USA underneath. So let me change to my master audience. And we'll wait for this to load and then we'll create those two. So I'll click create groups. So we need to create it exactly the same. So it was checkboxes. We called it interests. And we called these, was it Australia and USA? Okay, I'll just delete that. Click save. Okay, so we would do that for all our groups. We don't need to import or anything like that, but just replicate or create those groups. Really, really important in the new audience. Going back to our instructions. Okay, export contacts from the old audience. Now I showed you how to do that in the first step, backup existing audiences. So just create or download once again. Then we edit the exported file. So when we export from Mailchimp, we will get various, don't worry about this green one up the top, but we'll get various files named by the email marketing status. So subscribed, the CSV file called subscribed sorry, yes, yeah, subscribed, sorry, will include all people that are subscribed that we can send email marketing to. Unsubscribed relates to unsubscribed people. If I'd had cleaned, I would also have a cleaned one and maybe a non-subscribed one. When we're reporting, and this is so important, we must do the cleaned, the non-subscribed, and the unsubscribed before we import the subscribed people. But I'm jumping ahead. But anyway, what our instructions said here was edit the exported CSV files. So I've got here open in Google Sheets, but it could be in Microsoft Excel or any other CSV editor. You can see I've got various fields. And what I mean by edit these fields is remove the information that you don't necessarily want to import into the master audience. What other things I'll note here is you'll notice that my groups here would be here or are here. In other words, I had a group called interests, and you can see my various values underneath that and any other groups I'd see in a comma separated column. For my purposes, I'm going to delete a lot of this stuff that just I don't want to keep, and it's up to you what information you do keep, but I'm going to delete latitude. Let's get rid of all this stuff because I'm just not that interested in it. Region. Okay. I must, however, keep the tags on the end. That's important. So let me just delete all these columns. So I'll just go delete columns. Okay. So just to reiterate, these then are the columns I'm going to import, and it's up to you which you delete. Remember, I've still got my groups here and my tags column. You might have multiple groups columns, interests, favorite flavor, ice cream, whatever. Going back to our instructions, decide on your import order. This is where I was saying, just make absolutely certain that you first import your unsubscribed, cleaned, and non-subscribed, and you would import your unsubscribed with the status of unsubscribed, which I will show you. Your cleaned is cleaned. And last of all, you would import your subscribed people. This is just a demo, so I'm going to just go straight in and import the subscribed people. Okay, so decide on your import order. We've already done that. Then we import our contacts. So what I'll do here is I'll just copy all my information, including my tags and my interests, my groups. I'll go back to MailChimp. And what we want to do now, and let me just view all my audiences just to be sure where we are. So I exported that, I've worked on the file. I'm now going to import the subscribe people into the master audience. So I'm just going to click on the master audience name. To import people into this audience, and you may already have people in here, and that's absolutely fine. I'll just go add contacts, import contacts. And we're just going to follow the instructions. So do we want to upload? I will just copy and paste for now. I'll click continue. I'll just paste in my data, and it might look a bit strange. It doesn't look too bad here, but that's absolutely fine. And also the order of your columns can be anything. That's fine. We'll click continue. Wait for the next screen to load up. So I'm importing into my master audience. Yes, that's correct. I'm importing as subscribed. But again, if I was importing unsubscribed, I'd click unsubscribed and so on. But I'll click subscribed. Select my groups. I'm not going to select my groups at this stage because I have that column, and I'll show you how we match that up. But I'm going to ignore my groups for now, and I could go update any existing contacts. That's entirely up to you. I click continue to tag. Actually, let me just take a step back. If I at this stage selected groups and selected a group, for example, everyone that I'm importing would be imported into that group called Australia. We don't want that because some people belong to the USA, some to Australia, some to both, some to none. And there we go. So continue to tag. The same at this time. I'm not going to tag anyone right now, because anyone that I tag at this stage will tag everyone. And if we look back at our old, you know, what we're importing, some people are tagged as government, some as public training, etc. If I tagged someone, everyone would be, but I will show you how we tag people individually in a second, because we have that on our spreadsheet. But if I want to, I could at this stage add, let's call it the name of the old audience, just so I can recall who I imported and where they came from. I'll click continue to match. Wherever this is white, it means MailChimp recognizes the column. So that's the email address, that's the first name, that's correct, that's the last name, correct. And let's just carry on. Let me just click that. Now, MailChimp doesn't recognize MailChimp training. I haven't added that column to my master audience. I could have added it earlier. However, I can also do it at the moment. So I could click where it's orange. I could click the down arrow. And at this stage, I don't have a column called MailChimp training. So what I could do is I could just click create a new field and I could just call this, let's just say MailChimp training. I'll leave it as text data type and click confirm. And so this would add that new field. And you'll notice that my interests, which is actually my groups, now is recognized because I added those groups early on before I started the import. Also, the tags are now recognized. I click finalize import, complete import. I'll just click exit near the top of the screen. And let's just view. So there we go. There's my master audience. And let's just see what's happening here. We've got everything. We've got the tags. Some are tagged as SMEs, some as public training. Our interests, yes, I've got some people in USA, some in Australia and the USA. So now we've done this. We've brought through the groups, we've brought through the tags. One or two things we probably still want to do, however, is if I go back to my old audience. Now in MailChimp, most of us are on a plan where we pay for the number of people contact in our account, sort of. So because we have a lot of people, in this case not so much, but you might have a lot of people in your old audiences that you've combined, you might want to go into your old audiences. So I'm just going into my old audience. And what we can do here is we could select all and just archive these people. So actions, archive. So when we archive people, they're sort of held in the special container, I guess. We then still have our audience, but we're not charged for the people in that audience. At any time, I could go manage contacts and view my archive contacts and even unarchive them. But just looking at our audiences again, that I'm not going to be charged for anymore because I don't have people in it. But it hasn't been deleted, so I've got it there just as kind of a backup. But at any time, I could click that and click delete and delete my old audience if I want to, because they'll all now be in the master audience. Please like this video. Please subscribe. I hope this proved useful. Leave a comment. My name is Gary from organicweb.com.au.